folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on streaming objects to MinIO using Go. And in this video, we're going to be using Go 1.19. We're going to be streaming our objects up to play.min.io, which is our online sandbox where anybody can work with the MinIO platform. And we're going to be doing all of this out of VS Code. At the end of this how-to, you should be comfortable with the putObject function and also the putObjectOptions struct that's used to set some values for the object that you're going to upload, things like metadata and tags. We're also going to show you how to examine the results. Let's go ahead and take a look at some code. Okay, here is our demo Go file. This is part of our main package with our main method. I've got a few imports here. Probably the most interesting one is the MinIO demo MDF package, which has a very simple set of functions that I can use to scaffold my environment so that you can just focus on the code that we want to look at. I'm also importing the package MinIO Go version 7. That's our official release for our Go libraries. Let's go ahead and take a look at that main method. The first step is I'm going to call that PlayConnect. That's going to set up both my connection to MinIO, and it's also going to set up my Go demo bucket so that I can make sure that I can actually upload objects. Beyond that, I'm setting up a few variables here so that I can reuse them. My bucket name, Go demo bucket. I'm also setting up an object name, Hello World Text. And I'm going to be streaming a file. That file is a Hello World text file. It's just got some text in it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to open that file with a file reader using the OS open function. That gives me a file reader and it also gives me any errors. So I'm going to print out any errors if I have any there. So one of the cool things about Go is that I'm now calling this defer file close. This is really handy. I can open the file and then I can close it right here, but it's not going to actually perform the close until my main function is done. So this helps me to remember that I need to close these file readers. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get some statistics on my file. I need this because I'm going to use that to get the size of the file for uploading with the put object call. So I call this MinIO client with put object. There's a lot of variables that go into this. I need to have a context. I also have a bucket name, an object name, and this reader. Now the reader doesn't have to be a file reader. It just happens to be a file reader in this instance, but any reader that you can set up in Go can be used to stream data up to MinIO. I also need to have something about the object size. Now I want to get the entire file, so I'm going to get that file stat size to just hand it the entire file size. Last but not least, I have this put object options. Now the put object options also has a lot of variables that go into the struct. Things like the server-side encryption, you can set up user metadata, user tags. I'm just setting up a content type of text plain because this is a simple demo. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to check and see that what I uploaded actually worked. I'm going to get out the object name, that's the key. I'm going to get the bucket name. I'm going to pull out the e tag, the version ID, and then of course the size. So let's go ahead and run this. Go run. And when I run this, uploaded Hello World text to Go demo bucket. There is my e tag. The e tag is like a hash of the file so that I can make sure that anything has changed. I could upload another file that's the exact same file size, but if I had one letter changed, it would change the e tag. So that allows me to ensure that I'm actually looking at the file that I think I am. I also have this version and I have that size, 1567. Now that I know that the size is 1567, I can actually turn this off right here and say, let's give this a 1567, 1567. That's going to upload the same length of file. And if I rerun this, I'm going to see that my e tag is going to stay the same. My version will change. And of course, my size will stay the same. So let's take a look at that. There you go. Same e tag, different version, same size. The cool thing about uploading a stream is that I don't have to upload the entire size. If I want to change this, I can change this to say, oh, let's just do the first 512 bytes of this. And that's obviously going to change this. Now I have a new version. I also have a new e tag because the object has changed. Let's say though that I don't have any good way of determining the length of the stream that I'm going to be uploading. I can always put a minus one in here. And those of you who have seen a few of these how-tos are going to expect this to cause an error. It turns out that it does not. Most of the other uploads that we've done like this have required a part size, but with Go, Go is going to calculate that for me in the background on the fly just by giving it that minus one. Notice, however, my e tag is different. It's got a minus one there on the end. Of course, if I rerun this, I will get the same e tag again, so that's not really a problem, but it does represent a different object functionally from when I was uploading it with a known length. So that's really the main difference that you have there. And that's everything you need to know about streaming objects to MinIO using Go. I hope you've enjoyed this little how-to. If you'd like to connect with us, you can connect with us using any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can chat with us interactively on minio.slack.com or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.